So here we're going over a hominid evolutionary tree and kind of giving you some background information on some of the predecessors to the modern day Homo sapiens. So first off, we want to look at the hominid evolutionary tree, and there are two major groups of hominids. The genus Homo is comprised of about 3 to 7 species, depending exactly how you count them or classify them. The Australopithecus has 7 species, and they're older and smaller brained. These characteristics are bipedal, they're about 1 meter tall, about 18 kilograms in weight, and you can see kind of these different kind of structures to these individuals here in comparison to the Homo genus. And you can see the brain size is different, as well as the general structure and size of the individual on average. We can see this genre, the species, this subdivision, so we're getting more specific as we kind of break this apart. Fossils for these are only found in Africa, and the brains are not any larger than those if you compare them to apes. Now, within the early human migration pattern, there's a clade, and that's a group of organisms believed to have evolved from a common ancestor, according to the principles of cladistics, meaning all the individuals here can be traced back to one common ancestor amongst all. So early human migration pattern, you could see kind of this out of Africa model where we're looking at the oldest kind of components here, about 200,000 years ago in the red, and kind of the arrows pointing to the potential migration of those individuals. Now you can see that they migrated pretty much north, a couple went to the west, this region, up here into kind of what we know as modern day Europe and Asia, and then over into North America as well as Australia. What's kind of interesting to note is that if you look at the numbers, Australia occurred about 50,000 years ago, but New Zealand, not far geographically, as looking at mileage-wise, only 1,500 years ago. However, keep in mind that there is a not a lot of island jumps to occur to get to New Zealand. So this is the reason why, while they're not separated very far, if you were to measure them on a map like this, there's this large separation in time because of the isolation of New Zealand compared to that of Australia. Now, the last stages of hominid evolution, modern humans first appeared in Africa about 600,000 years ago. 3 human species were thought to have evolved. We're going to talk about these in a little bit more detail. And there's a link here and some images here of the different skull structures. So the first one here, Homo heidelbergensis, evolved from Africa about 600,000 years ago, migrated to Europe from Western Asia. It was the first early human species to live in colder climates. Their short, wide bodies were likely adapted for conserving heat. They had a reduced surface area to volume ratio. Lived in the oldest times, it defined control of fire and use of wooden spears. It's also the first early human species to routinely hunt large animals. So here's some defining characteristics. This early human also broke new ground and was the first species to build shelters, create simple dwellings out of wood and rock. So first kind of to establish a house or a living structure. We're looking here at Homo erectus, lived about 1.6 million years ago. Oldest known early humans to have possessed modern human-like body proportions with relatively elongated legs and shorter arms compared to the size of the torso. This means that they kind of lost that earlier tree climbing adaptations with the ability to walk and possibly run long distances, giving them the ability or more suited for long distance travel along land versus being able to more efficiently climb trees. The Homo neanderthalensis appeared in Europe about 130,000 years ago, just as the Homo heidelbergensis was becoming rarer. They likely branched off the ancestral line leading to modern humans. DNA has been recovered from these in more than a dozen Neanderthal fossils from Europe and also Asia. Their brains are just as large as ours, and there's evidence that they deliberately buried their dead, which is an interesting note. No other species had ever practiced this sophisticated behavior before, and they abruptly disappeared about 34,000 years ago. Now, Homo sapiens, the wise men, evolved from Africa, again, about 130,000 years ago, and they migrated to Europe and Asia, and then ultimately North America. This is called the recently out of Africa model. And this model is supported by a variety of gene studies, looking at mitochondrial DNA, X and Y chromosomes, and also autosomes. We as humans are unique animals and the product of evolution. Our evolution has been marked by a progressive increase in brain size, being able to have refined and extended conceptual thought, symbolic language, and cultural evolution as well. Now we're looking at major evolutionary transitions. We're seeing kind of this progression over time. We got the cells, the human evolution into brains. We're also now kind of going into the digital and potential bio-digital fusion of where we're looking at kind of that independent kind of technology being able to kind of work on its own, almost behave like a brain. So we're getting into where are we going from here. Now looking at evolution in general, kind of fun math for consideration, if the human generation time is about 25 years, that means over 100 years will be about four generations, as we try to show in the picture here. E. coli generation time, for comparison, only takes about 20 minutes. So that means E. coli can have essentially 72 generations in a single 24-hour period. Humans diverged from chimpanzees is estimated to be about 7 million years ago, which equates to about 280,000 generations. Now, for E. coli to go through that same time period, it'd only take about 3,800, almost 900 days, or a little over 10 and a half years. And it's been known that E. coli has been a significant public health problem since 1982, or 32 or so years ago. So this is kind of interesting how the rates of evolution may change or be altered. We're looking at cockroaches and sea lampreys have really not changed much in the last 300 million years. So this kind of brings apart the question here. I'm going to end it with, how do you think you got here? Where do you think you came from? Just some fun thoughts for consideration when you're talking about the subject of evolution. How did we get here? And where are we going?